I had a 3-year-old, a 14-year-old, and now I'm gonna go to school and get a master's. And I'm going to do this job all at the same time. But they agreed. Not only did they agree, they gave me the job. They also paid. And they paid and challenged me once I challenged them for the position. They challenged me that if I were going to go back and get a master's, that I should go back and get it from the best school that I could get it from, because they were going to pay for it. Wow. So I went back. I applied to both Northwestern and the University of Chicago and was accepted at both. Again, what I learned was instead of accepting the fee, I negotiated and earned what I wanted. This lesson taught me that no doesn't always mean no. It could just be the beginning point or an opportunity. Do not allow your mind to go down a negative path. It is always easy to say, poor me, they don't want me, it's because I'm black, it's because I'm a woman. I'm not discounting these issues because, you know, they are real and they do exist. I'm just here to tell you that you can't let those types of issues paralyze you and your thoughts. So let me tell you what happened. I went on to get my master's from the top school, Northwestern, on the company's dime. I morphed into a sponge. I worked and soaked up all the knowledge that I could from that position. And later I left and accepted a position that allowed me to have global responsibilities and taught me to learn business, gave me the opportunity to learn business on a global scale. With all of the effort that I put into this, one of the things that I will stress to you is never forget why you're doing the things you're doing. And in my case, my number one propeller was my children. And so, in the process of getting a master's and working on this great job and traveling around the world, it was also important to have work-life balance. And so, while I did not always be at everything and there for my children, I was always there when it counted, when they were sick, when there was a game, the things that matter. Because if we lose sight of why we do the things we do, then the things we do eventually don't lose their value. So moving on, 20 years later,